Well, hello. Welcome back to another exciting edition of Coffee with Steven. I am your minority blogger today. In fact, that's actually the title of the blog is I Am the Other. So as most of you are well aware, unless you've been living under a rock, California just had our recall election. Of course, there has been some grousing on the part of the pro-recall side that, like the Trump-Biden election, there's been some, you know, shenanigans taking place with the voting tallies and things like that. And that may entirely be true, but I honestly, seriously doubt it, at least not to the extent that it would overthrow the election. That all notwithstanding, it did highlight an important point, and it's something that really needs to be examined. You know, one of the most important things is not only understanding your enemy, so to speak, but also understanding yourself and where what assets you actually enjoy. And for years, those of us that are classical liberals have always harbored the belief system that there was this massive silent majority here in California that was only going to take it so long, and that when tyranny suddenly manifested and was becoming overarching, that these people would stand up with their pitchforks and their hoes and they would demand that, you know, the tyrants be taken out of office and tarred and feathered and everything else. Well, evidently that's not the case. In fact, we might be best described as perhaps a silent minority. Now, what's interesting is that this type of dynamic has taken place throughout all of human history, and we've seen it repeated, and there's a very specific type of organizational structure associated with this. You know, using blacks in the South, slaves more specifically, in the South, in antebellum southern states, you had two facets of white supremacy. You had what I refer to as the elite mandarins that were effectively running the systems in the state houses and within the bureaucracies and things like that. And these were the genteel white folk that, you know, effectively found their power base based on this idea of racial superiority. And then you had the great unwashed whites. You had all of these people that existed at the lower level of the income spectrum that didn't necessarily have a vested interest in white supremacy from an economic standpoint, but they did from an emotional standpoint, because regardless of how miserable their lives were, at least they weren't black. All right. And then, of course, you had that minority, the blacks themselves, right, that essentially had been marginalized and didn't really have any power. Well, in California, we see a similar type of organizational structure that's manifested. We've got the elite mandarins in Sacramento that are making all of these laws that, typically speaking, don't apply to them. And then you've got the great unwashed. You've got all of these masses, and they're not necessarily at different levels of the income spectrum. In fact, and oftentimes they might actually lead very comfortable lives, okay? But within their own social dynamics, they have a moral superiority, because as bad as their life may be, not necessarily, like I said, economic withstanding, but as bad as their life may be, at least they are morally superior to their neighbors who happen to be, God forbid, Republicans, okay? That there is that moral superiority, and we've seen that, right? We see that, you know, you've got the person who graduated from college with a social degree that is working in, you know, an hourly job, that is essentially railing against the, you know, the economic system that's created this sort of systemic exploitation of them. And, you know, as bad as things are for them, at least they are not Republicans, because the Republicans, regardless of whether or not they're at the same level of the income spectrum or they're much higher on the income spectrum, they are morally inferior to the, you know, barista or whatever it happens to be based on their political philosophy. Now, the Constitution actually created protections against this, okay? The Constitution mandated that there would be a certain established minority rights, things that were effectively off the policy table. And now we're seeing major pushes to reduce those or completely eliminate them. And candidly, we see them on both sides of the political aisle. When Republicans have been in power, we've seen a push to do that. Trump did it himself. Okay, so it shouldn't necessarily surprise us that it also comes from the Democrats. Irrespective of all that, it doesn't bode particularly well. So in any event, I want you to read the blog. You may agree with it, you may disagree with it. Feel free to comment. You can always comment directly on the blog, which will appear at artemishq.com/blog on Wednesday morning. You can also email me directly any comments that you have at stephen@artemishq.com. As always, I want you to train constantly, train consistently, train repetitively, train with purpose, and above all else, stay safe.